We learned that there was a suspect. They arrested him late this afternoon, and then they said it was his son-in-law, the son-in-law of the retired couple. And we have just learned some more information tonight that, in fact, this man you're looking at right here, 49-year-old Richard Parker, that he lived in the home behind his in-laws with their daughter. So it appears as though he was still married, but authorities convened a grand jury this afternoon at 4 p.m., and that grand jury returned four charges, two counts of premeditated murder, two counts of felony murder. He's being held on $1 million bail tonight.
I mean, it's just, it's, I know for a while they were saying, look, that they didn't, we were worried, we might not know who it was, whether other people could be at risk. So this was a big development. Now, what about the bomb itself? And we know there was questions, was it put in the mailbox? Was it put on the porch? I mean, how did they get it? And how, do you know much about it in terms of why it didn't explode until it was inside the house right where they opened it?
And this is why it's good to have press conferences, because it's been widely reported that it was in the mailbox, but what we're learning now that it was outside the front of the home, maybe leaning on something, and that's when John Setzer, 74 years old, part-time minister, retired civil lawyer, took the package inside. It exploded inside the house, instantly killing him. His wife, 72-year-old Marion, she was critically injured and died several days later.
And do you know anything about the relationship? Have they said at all about, I mean,
you're talking about motive, and we have not heard anything about motive. They say it will compromise the investigation. It's an ongoing investigation, but I think to have someone so close, obviously living on the property, what motivated someone to murder? This is a double murder now.
Right, people would know that there might have been some problem between the son-in-law and the parents. All right, well, let me bring in Jeff Fulton with the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms, and Explosives. He's the special agent in charge of the investigation. Thanks so much for being with us, sir. What can you tell us? I mean, as we're trying, Gene reporting here on the motive, I mean, what the motive might have been here.
Well, there obviously was a challenge between the family members, but we're not at the point where we want to discuss that, as we're still finishing up some leads and continuing the investigation.
I've been told, Jeff, that there was a note somehow left amid the debris. Was it, anyway, linked to the motive? Can you tell us what that was or what it said?
Yeah. I can't discuss what it said. It was not linked to the motive, and we know that it was placed there as opposed to delivered by some common carrier.
All right, but you're saying not linked to the motive, which obviously is important. So what about the relationship? But they're saying they lived sort of back-to-back houses, right? Was this man, the suspect, Richard Parker, still married to this couple's daughter?
I believe that's correct. They were currently married.
And can you tell us any more about the bomb itself, how this was designed? I mean, how sophisticated was the construction?
We're still have a lot of the bomb debris at our laboratory, and we are still investigating any possibilities that anybody else may be involved, although we're confident we have the person who was involved in this. We still want to close out some loose ends and try to determine if there's any chance anybody else was involved. So we're not really discussing at this point any of the particulars of the device construction.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Jeff. We appreciate that.